Hi students, this is me welcoming everyone to the English class with a happy good afternoon. Hoping everyone to have a full watch of the video. So in the last class, it is in the previous videos, we have seen stanza 1, 2 and 3 of our Casuarina tree. Hope everyone of you have understood. Now let us continue the fourth stanza. So we have completed third stanza with the lines. It's the tree's lament and airy speech that happily to the unknown land may reach. Okay, so the stanza 1, 2 and 3 were a bit easier to understand. But stanza 4 and 5 is little bit hard. So watch carefully and have a better understanding. So we have completed the third stanza with the ending lines. It is the tree's lament and eerie speech that happily to the unknown land may reach. Okay, so in this stanza, the poet Thordit describes the lament of the tree, and she says it as a strange speech. Okay, that happily that may possibly reach the unknown land. So actually, the tree is in the native of the poet Thordit, but now she is in France. Okay, so the poet says that she could hear the tree's lament in the unknown lands. Okay, and also we can have one more meaning to the unknown land. It means the place of death or the underworld. Okay, now let us start the stanza 4. Okay. Unknown, yet well known to the eye of faith. Ha, I have heard that wail far, far away, in distant lands, by many a sheltered bay, when slumbered in his cave, the water wraith, and the waves gently kissed the classic shore of France or Italy, beneath the moon, when earth lay tranced in a dreamless swoon. And every time the music rose, before mine inner vision rose a form sublime, thy form, O tree, as in my happy prime, I saw thee in my loved native clime. Right. Okay. So, unknown, yet well known to the eye of faith. Okay. So, the tree's lament may reach the unknown land to the unknown people. Okay, so it may reach the unknown land and also to the unknown people, and also it may reach the poet Thordit. Yet, okay, so you know what is mean by yet. So yet well known to the eye of faith. Okay, so to the eyes of faith, the lament is well known. Okay, so it will be well heard to the eyes of faith. Huh? I have heard that wail far, far away in distant lands. Right. See, I have heard that wail. So here wail means lament. Okay, so in the stanza 3 we have seen the word lament, dirge. Okay, so in this stanza we are seeing it as wail. So everything are synonyms. Okay, so I have heard that wail. So here I refers to the poet Thordit. I have heard that wail far. So even though I am in a far off land. So the poet was, the tree is actually in the native place, but the poet's family shifted to France and then later to Italy after his after her brother and sister's death. Okay, so I have heard that wail. So I have heard the poet had heard the lament of the Casuarina tree far, far away in distant lands. So even though I am staying in distant lands, I have heard the wail of the Casuarina tree in the past, and also in the present still I am hearing it. By many a sheltered bay, when slumbered in his cave the water wraith. Okay, by many a sheltered bay. So Now the poet is in a distant land. So as I said already, the casuarina tree is in its native, but the poet has switched to some other place. Now she is in a far off land, in a distant land. That is, she is in France. Okay. So by many a sheltered bay, so how the lament will reach the distant land to the place where the poet stays is, it will be crossing many places. So, okay. So, on the way, okay, it will be crossing many boundaries. It will be crossing many territories. It will be crossing the bay. It will be crossing the sea. And it will be reaching to the poet in the distant lands. That is the meaning here. Okay. By many a sheltered bay, so the lament crosses all the places, like boundaries in the next country, boundaries in the nearby village, territories, seas, the bays, everything it crosses and it reaches the poet who is in the distant land by many a sheltered bay. Okay. When slumbered in his cave, the water wraith and the waves gently kissed the classic shore of France or Italy. Okay. When slumbered. Okay, slumbered means in a state of sleep. Okay, slumbering means sleeping. So slumbered means in a state of deep sleep, deep asleep. Okay, so when slumbered in his cave, the water wraith. So listen, here wraith means apparition. Okay, so apparition means it denotes to a dead spirit. Okay, actually this water wraith is a phrase. Okay, so this phrase is taken from the Wordsworth poem Yarrow Visited, 1814. Okay, so this phrase water wraith is taken from the Wordsworth poem titled, that is the name of the poem is Yarrow Visited, 1814. Okay. So, in that poem, the meaning of this apparition is dead spirit. Okay. Dead spirit. So, one more meaning we can say for apparition is water god. Okay. Water god. Here, what meaning we can match to this is, we can so here we can match the meaning water god. Okay, so here for this phrase water wraith, so wraith means apparition. One meaning is dead spirit as per the Wordsworth poem Yarrow Visited. One more meaning is water god. Okay. So, here we can match the meaning water god. So, when slumbered in his cave, the water wraith. So, what is going on is, okay. So, water god abdina, what we can say, kadal devam soluvalliya, that is, okay. So, the water god is in a state of deep sleep. So, the god is deep asleep in its cave. Okay. And the waves gently kissed the classic shore of France or Italy. Okay. So, the waves are kissing the shore of shore in France and Italy. So, here where is the poet now? Now, she is in France. Okay, France, and later she switched to, that is, she shifted to Italy. From her native place, she first went to France after her brother and sister's death, and then their family went to Italy. Okay, beneath the moon. So, beneath means under the moon. When earth lay tranced in a dreamless swoon. Okay, so the meaning of tranced. Okay, so what is the meaning of trance is, just you have to imagine the meaning. It is a mental state in which we doesn't know what goes around us. Enna sollalam ipo oru nalla deepa oru yoga pannit irukanga ஆர் இன் ஓல்டன் டேஸ் அந்த செயின்ஸ் எல்லாம் என்ன பண்ணுவாங்க, தவம் பண்ணுவாங்க இல்லையா? ஸோ தே டோன்ட் நோ வாட் இஸ் கோயிங் அரவுண்ட் தெம் வென் தே ஆர் இன் த ஸ்டேட் ஆஃப் ட்ரான்ஸ். தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ட்ரான்ஸ். கேன் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? ஸோ நம்மளை சுற்றி என்ன நடக்குது அப்படிங்குறது, அதை பற்றின ஒரு கான்ஷியஸ்னஸ் இல்லாமல் இருக்க ஒரு ஸ்டேட் இருக்கும் இல்லையா, தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ட்ரான்ஸ். மோஸ்ட்லி வி கேன் மேட்ச் அண்ட் த செயின்ஸ் வில் பி இன் த ட்ரான்ஸ் ஸ்டேட். அவங்கெல்லாம் அந்த தவம் பண்ணுவாங்க இல்லையா? ஸோ அப்போ அவங்களோட ஸ்டேட், அவங்களோட ஸ்டேஜ் எப்படி இருக்கும், மென்டல் ஸ்டேஜ் எப்படி இருக்கும் அப்படின்னா, தே டசன்ட் நோ வாட் இஸ் கோயிங் அரவுண்ட் தெம். தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ட்ரான்ஸ். நவ் வாட் த போயட் சேஸ், வாட் இஸ் ட்ரான்ஸ், இங்கே என்ன, வாட் இஸ் இன் ட்ரான்ஸ் ஸ்டேட், வாட் இஸ் இன் ட்ரான்ஸ் பொசிஷன் இஸ் வென் எர்த் இஸ் இன் த ட்ரான்ஸ் பொசிஷன். ஓகே, வென் எர்த் இஸ் இன் அ ட்ரான்ஸ் ஸ்டேட், when earth lay tranced in a dreamless swoon. Okay, swoon means losing consciousness, in a state of losing consciousness. Okay, see now what is the meaning of this, what is the meaning of this lines is, okay, when earth is in a transposition, when that is when all the people living in the earth, okay, when all the people living in the earth were deep asleep, which time? Beneath the moon. So beneath the means during the night time. Can you understand? So when all the people in the earth are deep asleep during the night time, and when the waves are kissing, so during the night times there will be gentle waves, right? So the sea will be little bit calm and the waves will be gentle. Okay, so when all the people in the earth were in a deep sleep, okay, when they are in a trance state, when they are in deep sleep during the night time, that is under the moon, and when the waves are gently kissing the shores of France and Italy, okay, and also when the water god is also deep asleep in its cave. Okay, so the water god is also sleeping deeply in its cave. Okay, the poet Thordit could hear the veil, she could hear the veil of the casuarina tree. So during this time when everything is quiet during the night time, the poet is able to hear the veil of the casuarina tree. It is reaching the poet by crossing all the distant lands, that is by crossing all the boundaries and all the territories, etc. It is reaching the poet. Can you understand? So these last lines say that the poet is missing the casuarina tree because she is filled with lots of memories under the tree. Could you understand? So if you can understand better if you are going from reverse from this line. Okay, see, when everyone in the earth is in a deep sleep, okay, everyone is taking rest during the night time, and when the waves are gently kissing the shores of France or Italy, and also as it is night time, the water god will be in a deep sleep, water god will also take rest in its cave. Now the poet could hear, in such a trance situation, in such a silent situation, in a calm situation, the poet was able to hear the lament of the casuarina tree as it is crossing everything and it is reaching the poet in the unknown land. Okay, now come to the next lines. And every time the music arose before mine inner vision, rose a form sublime, thy form, O tree, as in my happy prime, I saw thee in my own loved native clime. Okay, so what it means is, and every time the music rose before mine inner vision, okay, and every time when the music, so here music refers to the lament of the tree, okay, and every time, each and every time when the poet was able to hear the lament of the casuarina tree, see, Here the poet is not actually hearing Nijamavi and the tree is not going to lament. Tree ku pesa theriyadhu, it will not lament. Okay. But the poet imagines so because she is as much missing the Casuarina tree because her mind is filled with lots of reminiscence about her childhood days as she used to play under the Casuarina tree along with her siblings, right? So, and when every time the poet hears the music, when every time the poet remembers her childhood days, before mine inner vision, mine refers to the poet Thoridan. Mine inner vision arose a form sublime. Okay, so here vision, all of you know what is the meaning of vision. So, what is the inner vision of the poetess? So, what is going on in her inner vision is, okay, so what are all going on in her inner vision? All the things that we have seen in the previous three stanzas, that is, a creeper is climbing, because as the creeper is climbing the trees with many scars in its trunk, and also it is having lots of crimson colored flowers, and throughout the day it is filled with the birds and bees. Okay, and also the birds used to sing in the tree, and every time when the poet opens the window, she could see the baboon sitting and watching the sunrise, young ones playing, birds singing, cows going to the pastures, and below the shadow of the tree in a pond, it is filled with the water lilies, which is like a snow spreaded ground. Okay, and also she could remember the deep love which she had for her brother and his sister, and the trees lamenting, everything she is remembering. Okay, all this refers to the inner vision. So if a question is asked, what is inner vision, or what does inner vision mean here, means these are all coming back to her mind. That is the inner vision of the poet here. Okay. Mine inner vision rose a form sublime. Okay. So, in her mind, she could see the grandness of the majesty of the Casuarina tree. Okay. In her inner vision, she could remember the majesty of the Casuarina tree and all the things. Okay. What I said. Thy form, O tree, as in my happy prime I saw thee in my own loved native clime. Thy, so thy, it is an old dialect form. It means you are. Okay. Thee means you. Okay. Thy form, O tree. So, here why the letter T is capitalized is, so usually where we will be using the capital letter for the names of proper noun. So tree is also a noun, but for the name of proper noun we'll be mostly using, right? So why here T is capitalized is because it is personified like a person. Okay, already you know it, the tree is the poet says the tree is lamenting, it is crying, it is worrying, it is expressing its sorrow, everything we have seen. So the tree is personified like a human being, that's why the letter T is capitalized here, right? So O tree, as in my happy prime, I saw thee. So, thee means you. I refers to the poet. Thee refers to the tree. Okay. So, as in my happy prime. So, during my childhood days, I have spent lot of time with you happily. And as how I am remembering you in my inner vision now. In my own loved native clime. So, clime means here climate. Okay, so in my native climate, I used to play under you with all my siblings and I have spent a lot of happy time under you. So, all those things I could remember you, all those things I could remember now when I think about my past memories. Okay, so this is given in this stanza, right? So, and unknown yet well known to the eye of it. So the poet, whenever she hears the lament of the, that is whenever she recalls the Casuarina tree, she is remembering all these things under the, about the Casuarina tree. Okay, now let us go for the fifth stanza. I think you have understood the fourth one. Now let us see the fifth stanza, right? So therefore, I fain would consecrate your lay unto thy honor tree, beloved of those who now in blessed sleep for a repose, dearer than life to me, alas, were they. Mayst thou be numbered when my days are done with deathless trees like those in Barrowdale, under whose awful branches lingered pale fear, trembling hope, and death the skeleton, and time the shadow, and though weak the verse that would thy beauty feign, ho, fain rehearse, may love defend thee from oblivion's curse. Right. Therefore, I fain would consecrate a lay unto thy honor. So, listen. So, what is mean by fain is eagerly or gladly, very happily. Okay, I fain. So, the poet would eagerly consecrate a lay. So, what is mean by consecrate is, okay, to officially make something holy. So, if we are building a new temple, in a panuo, we will be consecrating the temple with the holy waters, with the water taken from the holy rivers. Illaya, enna panuo, oru pudusa oru kovil kattrona, அதுக்கு கும்பாபிஷேகம் பண்ணும்போது என்ன பண்ணுவோம், வி வில் பி கான்சக்ரேட்டிங் த டெம்பிள். அந்த டெம்பிள் கோபுரத்தை என்ன பண்ணுவோம், வி வில் பி கான்சக்ரேட்டிங் அப்படின்னா என்ன பண்ணுவோம், அதை புனிதப்படுத்துவோம். எப்படி பண்ணுவோம், வி வில் பி பிரிங்கிங் த வாட்டர்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் த ஹோலி ரிவர்ஸ் அண்ட் வி வில் பி கான்சக்ரேட்டிங் த டெம்பிள், ரைட்? அந்த மாதிரி ஐ வுட் கான்சக்ரேட், த போயட் வுட் லைக் டு கான்சக்ரேட் எ லே. லே மீன்ஸ் a person who is interested in making something. See here, the lay means amateur. Amateur means a person who is very interested in making something to somebody or something. Okay, I think you can understand. So here the poet would like to consecrate what does the poet would like to consecrate? She likes to consecrate the காஷரினா ட்ரீயை கான்சக்ரேட் பண்ணணும்னு ஆசைப்படுறாங்க. ஓகே, ஐ வுட் கான்சக்ரேட் எ லே அன்டு தை ஹானர். ஸோ தை மீன்ஸ் யார், அன்டு த ஹானர். வை ஷீ லைக்ஸ் டு கான்சக்ரேட் இஸ் பிகாஸ் ஷீ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு கான்சக்ரேட் தட் காஷரினா ட்ரீ, டு கிவ் அ ஹானர் டு இட், டு கிவ் அ ரெஸ்பெக்ட் டு த ட்ரீ. Why she wants to give a honor to the tree is beloved of those who now in blessed sleep for I repose. Okay, beloved because as a remembrance of her love, to whom, who now in blessed sleep, who here refers to, can you identify whom does who refers to? Who refers to her brother Abju and her sister Aru. Okay, who now in blessed sleep. So who are sleeping now? So sleeping means here it is not sleeping. So they were died. Yeah, so they were died of tuberculosis already. So they were in blessed sleep for a repose. So repose means in a state of being rest. So here they are in a state of permanent rest because they were dead. So she wants to consecrate the Kasharina tree. Okay, for the honor, to give her respect for their beloved ones. So, to her beloved sister and brother who are in a state of death now, they are blessed asleep. So, here blessed asleep and I repose refers to the both are synonymizing death. Okay, so they were dead now. So, as a remembrance for them, I want to consecrate them. Kasharina tree, I want to immortalize the Kasharina tree, that is consecrating. The poet wants to immortalize the Kasharina tree, dearer than life to me. Okay, because the Kasharina tree is very dearer, very loving, very lovely, very much important than comparing to the life. The Kasharina tree is very much loving to the poet. Alas, were they. So here they refers to whom? they refers to her brother and sister, and also as how my brother and sister is very much loving to me, the cashew nut tree is also very much loving to me. That's why I want to immortalize the tree, cashew nut tree, by writing a poem, and that's why I have written this poem. That's why the poet Thorudit had written this poem, because she wants to consecrate the cashew nut tree as a remembrance to her loving brother and sister, and as a reminiscence to her childhood days. Mayst thou be numbered when my days are done with deathless trees. So here mayst means may. So thou means you. Okay, thou means you. It is a old dialect form. So may you be. So many other persons. May you be numbered when. May you be numbered. So may you be numbered means already many poets have written many poems in a remembrance of somebody or something. ஏற்கனவே நிறைய போயட் இந்த மாதிரி இம்மார்டலைஸ் பண்ணியோ கான்சக்ரேட் பண்ணியோ ஒரு ரிமெம்பரன்ஸாவோ நிறைய பேருக்கு ஆர் நிறைய திங்ஸ்க்கு தே ஹாவ் ரிட்டன் மெனி போயம்ஸ். ஸோ மே யூ பி நம்பர். ஸோ நானும் அதில் ஒரு ஒரு பர்சனாக இருப்பேன். ஐ ஆல்சோ வில் பி அ பர்சன் இன் தட் லிஸ்ட். ஓகே, வென் மை டேஸ் ஆர் டன் வித் டெத்லெஸ் ட்ரீஸ் லைக் தோஸ் இன் பாரோடேல். ஸோ here Borrowdale means listen. So Borrowdale is the name of a valley. Okay, so in that valley, so where is this valley? Is it is in a village called Lorton. Okay, Lorton gra village la there is a valley called Borrowdale. Okay, so the poet William Wordsworth. So in that valley Borrowdale, there is a tree called yew tree. Okay, there is a tree called yew tree. So the poet William Wordsworth had written a poem called yew tree, which has 33 lines. So that poem has 33 lines, and William Wordsworth had written a poem on yew tree. Okay, so it is believed that the tree is 1000 years old, and still the tree is present there in that Borrowdale Valley, in the village called Lorton. Still now we can see the tree. Okay, so William Wordsworth had written a poem on yew tree, immortality poem. Okay, so he had also written a poem on yew tree. Likewise, I am also going to write, the poet Thorudit is also going to write a poem on the Casuarina tree. Okay, under whose awful branches lingered pale. Okay, so why the poet wants to write is because lingered. So lingered means staying in some place, reluctant to live. Oru place vittu pogurathukku manasu varama will be staying in that. இன்னும் கொஞ்ச நேரம் இருக்கலாம்னு தோணும் இல்லையா? சம் பிளேசஸ் இஃப் வி கோ, இங்கே அந்த இடத்த விட்டு போக மனசு வராமல் இருப்போம் இல்லையா, தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் லிங்கரிங், பிகாஸ் ஷி ஹேட் லாட்ஸ் ஆஃப் மெமரிஸ் அண்டர் த ட்ரீ. ஸோ லைக் த போயட் வேர்ட்ஸ்வர்த் ஹூ ஹேட் ரிட்டன் அ போயம் ஆன் யூ ட்ரீ இன் த விச் இஸ் இன் த பாரோடேல் வேலி, த போயட் தோரதத் ஆல்சோ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு ரைட் எ போயம், இம்மார்டலிட்டி போயம், ஆர் ஷி வாண்ட்ஸ் டு கான்சக்ரேட் எ போயம் ஆன் த காஷரின ட்ரீ. ஓகே, see this yew tree, and the yew tree ingra name kelvi padale all the persons will remember the poet William Wordsworth. Likewise, the poet Thorudit wishes that whoever is hearing the word Casuarina tree, okay, so everyone should remember her love towards her brothers and sister, and that's why she wants to write a immortality poem on Casuarina tree, and that's why she had written this poem. Okay, fear, trembling hope and death, the skeleton and time the shadow. See here, listen here, what fear symbolizes is, so already the poet's brother Abju and her sister Aru were dead in earlier age. Why? Because they suffered from tuberculosis. Now we have seen that the poet Thorudit was also died in the age of 21 because she also suffered from same tuberculosis. Now she is in the death bed. Okay, so she is almost to die. So that's it is at the time she had written this poem. So that's why she is in a state of fear. Okay, trembling hope. And also she lost her confidence that she will be living for some more time. Okay, trembling hope and death. And she knows that as how her brother and sister were died of tuberculosis, she is also going to die. Skeleton. So it also refers to death. Both will synonymize deathly state. Okay. And time the shadow. Okay. And time is following her like a shadow because she is going to reach her death. That is the meaning of this words given in inverted commas. Understand? So now she is in this. This is her condition now. She is in a death bed. Because she is also suffering from tuberculosis and she is counting her day. She doesn't know when she is going to die. And though weak the verse means here lines. So here the poem lines. Though weak the verse. So listen, this lines shows her humbleness, simplicity. It shows the simplicity of the poet. So actually this is a very good poem. Okay, so even though it is a very good poem, she says that though weak the verse in the poem oru weakana poem a irundalum. Okay, so actually it is not a weak poem, it is actually a very good poem. Many critics have criticized many thing positive about this poem. They were attracted and they have given written criticism. Already ungala criticism na enna nu sollirken. So they have given many good criticism on this poem. Okay, so but even though inga avanga weak nu sollirukirathu, what it symbolizes is, it symbolizes her simplicity, her humbleness and her humility. Okay, so though weak the verse, so weak a irundalum, that would thy beauty feign. Okay, so feign means already we have seen very eagerly or happily or gladly. Okay, so I would for your beauty feign, so I would eagerly, happily would like to write this poem or as a immortality poem, or I would like to consecrate the tree. Ho feign rehearse. So rehearse means a repeat. Okay, because again I am repeating, happily I am repeating this poem as a consecration to the Casuarina tree. May love defend thee from oblivion's curse. So oblivion means forgetfulness. Okay, curse na enna, what is that, boon, ban, solluvom illaya, curse na saabam. Okay, boon na varam, curse na saabam. Okay, so oblivion's curse appadina, okay, so even though, so may love defend thee from oblivion's curse. So here, so already I have said, oblivion means forgetfulness. Okay. Curse means savam. Okay. So, it is the nature of everyone to forget. Okay. So, it is the nature of everyone, all the human being to forget. So, oblivion means forgetfulness. So, curse means, what is it? Savam. Okay. So, why I am writing, that is why the poet is writing this poem, is because by writing this poem she wants to save us from the curse called forgetfulness. So it is nature of all the human beings to forget. Marakkiradhungiradhu, it is common for all the human beings. So and the maradhingra oblivion, so maradhi abdingra curse, saabam, saabathil irundhu I am going to save everyone by writing this poem. Okay, so may love defend. Defend means protect. Protect thee. Thee means you from oblivion's curse. So, no one wants to forget this Casuarina tree. That's why I am writing this poem. Understand? So, in this stanza, the poet is, see, this in this line, she is in a lonely place. Already she had lost her brother and sister. Now she is in a deathbed. She is also suffering from tuberculosis. Okay, so she wants to write a poem because it shows the love which she had for the Casuarina tree and the love which she had for her native place and the love which she had for her siblings. Okay, so as how everyone is, when whoever hears the word yew tree will remember the poet Wordsworth. Likewise, whoever hears the word Casuarina tree should remember the poet Thordir. So why? Because that is the love which she had on her siblings and also under the Casuarina tree. That's why she is writing this poem as a remembrance. Okay, so I hope every one of you have understood. Let me sum up in the next class. Thank you for watching. Thank you.